This is you got to put in the ba like what is going on? You got to put in the bathroom? What is
No, I'm in like the utility basement area. Like, I don't want to tell you what's going
this?
on in this place, but it's dark.
We
It's a dungeon. You can see I got a spotlight in my face because the lights in the area, I had to brighten it up because like the camera wasn't picking it up. So I had to brighten it up. I'm all lit up. What a week. What a time. Let's get this thing started in 5, 4, 3. Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Schmidt and Lavelle. My name is Tom Lavelle, and as always, I'm accompanied by Mr. Timothy Schmidt.
a little bit of a new look right now.
For those of you that are just
After.
listening, I'm currently recording from the dungeon, and it's a little musty in here. It's a little hot. The lights are bright, but we're making it work here on Schmidt and Lavelle as we always do, right, Timmy? We're putting out new episodes every week. We appreciate you listening. If you're not already doing it, please give us that follow. New episodes every week. The show is growing. Views are up, likes are up, shares are up. Everything's up, up, up. We can't do it without you. I'm on vacation this week, and Timmy, would you say I've been MIA?
It's been pretty evident that you're on vacation. We really have not communicated. We have been ill communicato for quite some time here. But hey, Tom, look, you are on vacation with your family. It's very important to do that and decompress and be present with your family and put decompress.
I'm compressing. I'm compressed. There's no decompression going on here.
Yeah, and you know, like that's what you need to do. You throw the put the technology down for a little while, you know, and just focus in on the ones that love you, Tom, and the ones that you love.
It is important to make these memories. However, Timmy, you know, with kids, when you go on vacation, a lot of times it's not much of a vacation. And that's not a complaint, but there's a lot of extra things that go into it, and a lot of more effort, a lot of work to make these memories that it's all about the kids. But we're going to get into all of that. But before we get into that, let's get into some of our comments and calls that we've had from last week. Timmy, another successful video for us. Thousands of views. The putt heard round the world from CMAC 1010. Tom plays for the jacket next year. That Eagles kid says the celebration, LOL. Mike McD 53. How many takes? Nikki Lavelle working hard today, Thomas. Roberto Bird. Better than practicing in the bathtub. Photon underscore recorder. That's not a bad idea. Kupchak played the break perfectly. R Fleming 04. You've got to be kidding me. Timmy, what'd you think of the putt?
It's a great putt. It's a great putt, Tom. I know the lay of the land there, and it is a hard putt to read. I haven't had that exact putt, you know, on that hole before. But what you did there was incredible because the pace was good, the stroke was good. Wasn't expecting it to trickle in like it did, but I mean, you nailed it. You nailed it. I don't know how many takes it took, but I mean,
in all
it was
honesty, I would say the amount of takes it took to get that shot was probably 20 something. You know what I mean? Like 20 shots it took, maybe. I forget
so
because I was like hitting it and then there, what happens is there's like a ridge there. So you have to like ride the ridge and then just have it come in. If you take it to the one side, it goes off the edge, you know? So I didn't want it to, I was trying to play it like the US Open, where the greens were super fast. And what an incredible US Open. We got to talk about that real quick, Tim. What were your thoughts about that? And Rory McIlroy coming down the stretch, Bryson DeChambeau becoming your winner. What'd you think of that tournament and how it played out? Much different than the PGA Championship.
One of the greater, I would say in the last probably decade, I would say it's probably one of the best major golf tournaments we've had in probably over 10 years. Just because you had so much firepower at the top of the leaderboard. You had two guys, one representing LIV, the other representing the PGA Tour, one who I mean, Rory McIlroy has carried a torch for the PGA, has been the spokesperson, has been the greatest, the good guy essentially in this whole LIV versus, the PGA Tour thing. And then Bryson, who was really a villain for quite some time, in that whole, if you remember back the Brooks
Yeah.
Koepka, the Bryson DeChambeau thing where Bryson bulked up and he was trying to just dominate courses and like Brooks just had no time for it. And look, what he has done in terms of his reputation has really been unprecedented. Like the guy was getting ridiculed almost at every golf tournament. He goes to live and essentially rehabilitates his image. He goes off the tour for a little while, so he doesn't hear those Brooksy chants anymore. And he starts like connecting really with the audience more than any golfer that you've ever seen. I mean, I've never seen a golfer in the middle of a tournament in a major or any golf tournament fist bumping the fans, just like just it looked like he was like a gladiator. In the middle of like Maximus, right? Like in that
Yeah.
movie where he's egging on the fans and he's like he's it was almost like Happy Gilmore-esque, right? Like,
Kind
I mean, not to that extent,
of
but
like
to the
your every
point.
man's player, you know? He's very, very likable in that sense.
Yeah,
And
and
I didn't like him before, Tim. I'm one of those people, and I have a theory to why his popularity rose. He got rid of the Jeff
well,
cap,
let's hear it.
went to a regular baseball cap. I don't know what it was. Something about that Jeff cap, I was like, this guy's a douche. And then I saw him play in one of those the match. I think he was paired up with like Aaron Rodgers or whatever. And he wore a regular hat, and I was like, I kind of like this guy, you know? And I was like, maybe it's the hat.
What about, I mean, Payne Stewart wore the Jeff cap.
Well, I'm not going to speak
Is he
ill w ill of the dead, but nah, just more Bryson. It was more Bryson. Never had an issue with Payne because he had the knickers, the pants all the way up, you know? So he did the full thing.
But I, yeah, and I, dude, honestly, I just, I loved it. I mean, the coverage was okay. It wasn't really great, but you got to see a lot, like 95% of the tournament, which is great. And just the way Rory choked it away was something that will be talked about for years and years and years. I mean, this is going to go up with, the Jan Vandeveld, Open Championship. It's going to go up there with Greg Norman with the Masters in '96. I mean, throw it up there. I mean, this dude just completely, he had a two-stroke lead and bogeyed three of the last four holes and missed two 3-foot putts.
Yeah,
And
hard to
it's
watch.
just inexcusable, and it's tough. It's so hard to watch. It's so inexcusable for a player that caliber to miss those types of shots, where, like, in the other end, you see like Bryson DeChambeau on the 18th hole. If you watch the tournament, you see him. He hooks the ball into the rough, and then he's able to hit a crazy shot into a bunker, and then gets up and down from a bunker from 55 yards away with one of the most incredible shots in the world. He does that from 55 yards and then makes a 4 foot putt. And Rory just he just couldn't do it. And he just folded under pressure. And it's such a shame because I mean he has been the guy, and you've pulled for him over the years. So I also have some vitriol towards him too because he cost me $3,600. So.
Yeah, so I
So
hear what
fuck
you're
him.
saying, and I wanted him to win because I feel like he's kind of the good guy in this situation if he's with the PGA Tour. So I hate to see him someone collapse like that, but things happen, and like you said, it'll be a tournament that we talk about. The tournament ended on Father's Day. I love that the US Open always ends on the final Sunday of Father's Day. Makes it really cool to watch over the years the players embrace their dad or maybe their new dads themselves, and their kid comes out and stuff like that. Timmy, how was your Father's Day? How did things go? Did you get to enjoy yourself? Did you get to relax? Did you get to spend time with the kiddos?
What a great Father's Day, man. Like we really had a day. And one of the things that we like my kids love to do is they love to go swim. Like that's their thing. Like they will sit in a pool for 15 hours if they could. And so we went over to my Aunt Betty's house, who has a nice pool. And I've talked about this place before. We put out videos of me doing wrestling moves with my kids in that pool. So me and my cousin Rob, we cook out, we do all sorts of things, and we let the kids swim, and they his he has kids that are the same age, and they swim all day, and then we just cook out, we listen to music, have a beer or two, and just enjoy the day. And that's I think what Father's Day really is. It's like, I know Mother's Day, right? And I'm gonna get into this dynamic real quick. Mother's Day is more like you have to plan a dinner and we have to go to this and we got to do that, right? Like dads just kind of just want to chill or relax or do what pleases them. I guess it's more selfish in a way, right? Like we're just like, hey, I want to do what I want to do. And moms are like, let's get the family together and have a huge dinner, and everyone's gonna come over. It's gonna be a great time. And then you're like, fuck, God damn it. So that's
Different
exactly what I love.
dynamics, Father's Day and Mother's Day. It is what it is, you know. The dads are just like, my wife, what do you want to do? And I'm like, nothing. I don't know. You know, she's like, well, we can go to the beach and get something to eat. And I'm like, well, weren't we gonna do that anyways? Like, yeah, that's what we'll do. You know, we're down the shore. And I just said, I mean, I love the little cards. Now I have a child that just graduating kindergarten, another one in daycare. And so they made like in school, like a grill spatula that says number one dad on it. And then my youngest son made like a keychain where they shrunk down his like handprint or something like that. And it's a key. So I love that stuff and the cards and them just saying, happy Father's Day because that's all I really care about. You know what I mean? There's nothing, I don't need really much more. Now, a round of golf would be nice. You know, I like, hey, like, let me get a round of golf and don't bother me.
I mean, that's probably the one thing that I would love to do on Father's Day is go out and play around the golf, but I think that's going to come later in life, like when your kids are older and they're like, let's have breakfast in the morning, and like that, you go do whatever you gotta do, like,
Yeah,
and
right.
okay. Like your kid's like, I know it's Father's Day. I'm not gonna bother you. All right, I get it. Like, cool. Oh, awesome. Yeah, beautiful. But yeah, I do like right now. My favorite thing to do with on Father's Day is just like spend time with my kids, dude. Like that's and it's an extra day that I get, and I'm able to cherish that time with my kids. And like I was telling you earlier, like I get now, like my kids are 9 and 11. Like you're at the early stages this time where
Right.
You're getting those like handmade cards, right? Where, it's like crayon. It's like
Yeah.
dad spelled backwards, and all the word like there's vowels that are consonant. Like you're just like, what does this
Yeah.
even mean? And you're
Can I
like, all
say
right, but
something here?
it's awesome. And now, like I'm getting into where the kids want to get me gifts, and they're using like their aunt to help out with the situation. So like, my gift this year was a golf shirt, except the golf shirt wasn't like a Travis Matthew, like beautiful golf shirt. Like it was a golf shirt with both my kids' faces all over it.
Even better.
Was just plastered all over it. And I'm like, yeah, I'm wearing this every time I golf now. Like it's like even better, right? And then I got a bracelet with like my kids' names on it, and then we have this expression that we say to each other, and every time they come down, like I do this thing. It's a Jim Harbaugh thing. I don't know if you remember this, but he had this expression with his team where he would say, "Who's got it better than us?" And it's nobody, right? So like I do that with my kids all the time. Like we do that, and that was like on the imprint of the bracelet. So my sister had a little bit of input on that too as well. So I
Ah,
got
very good.
I got the bracelet plus the shirt, which is fantastic, right? And like the funny thing about this whole process, right, as a father, like when you get gifts, it's like the stages of gifts, as a dad, like, or the stages of gifts as a kid. Like you don't know what to get your dad, so you just try to do the best you can. Like you come up, like you grab like a I remember one time I got my dad like for Father's Day, I got him like a country like tape. I was in like Sam Goody. It was like $12. And I just was like, I know he likes country music. I'm just gonna grab this tape, and I wrapped it up and gave it to him, right? Like, so like that's probably like when you're anywhere between like 12 or 10 and like 14, when you're like getting them just like random shit that costs like $20 or less.
Yeah.
Like when you're like 10 or 10 or below 10, you're probably getting them just like a card with like, I don't know, like you draw them a picture or whatever.
Yeah.
Like, and then like after like 15, 16, when they're starting to work on their own, like now that like the gifts start to get a little bit better, like you start get like I remember I was getting my dad like the golf nail book, where like it was like discounted golf, what
Oh,
you would call it, green,
yeah.
like greens fees everywhere. My dad was
Right.
like, this is awesome, like $20 off everywhere I go. It's like incredible. So I'm looking forward. Look, I love these gifts right now. Like they're great. And we're like at the very start of it. But like I'm looking forward like down the line, and
How'd that country music CD take? Was it a success, or was he like, oh,
it was
great, thank you.
dude, it was like the Hacksaw Ridge Boys, or no, no, I remember, actually it was the Oak Ridge Boys I got.
The Oak Ridge Boys. I got my dad once. It was so he liked like Frank Sinatra and like Bing Crosby and like old school like singers like that. We always listen to Sundays with Sinatra. And so we were in the store and I saw like a Bing Crosby CD. And like it was him like sitting on a fish boat. And like there's like five songs on it. I was like, he'll love this.
This is
It's like
great.
$3. That's like I got it for him. Like, what a
Yeah.
terrible gift.
It's like, Dad, you hold on to that? No, that went right in the trash.
You got any good ones? You got a good a Father's Day gift that you got your dad that was like, oh, I nailed this one.
Dude, I got him when I was like making like decent money. I think it was like right out of college. I got him like a new set of like of woods. So I got him like a new driver, like 3 wood and a 5 wood.
Oh, nice.
And he was like so pumped. I was like, dude, this is it was like one of the best gifts I ever got him. And he was like all fired up. He was like, oh, this is great. And like this is when he was playing golf probably twice a week, like once twice a week. He was going out all the time. And I didn't even know if I got him the right stuff because, like, then I didn't know what the hell. Actually, I was probably like 15 or 16. Maybe I was like, like right around that age. Because when I was older, I knew what the hell I was buying. But when he opened up that like set, he was stoked. Like you're really like scratching where he itches. You're like, oh, okay, here we go. And then, like once he loved that gift so much, I knew that all I had to do for every like birthday, during Christmas, like for Father's Day, all I had to do was go right to golf. Like that was it. Like, balls. Like I get him a new club or like new golf shoes or whatever it was.
The
Like I
book.
just, yeah, the book. It was just money. It was just such an easy gift. It was beautiful.
That is sweet. The book, we always used to make fun of Nicole's dad for the book because that's like what they would get him every year for Christmas or something like that, or Father's Day or whatever. And it was like, you got to get him the book so he can go play at
Like
Mecobee
20 hours off
Run.
between 10 and 12 o'clock on Monday through Thursday, and he was like, yes.
Yeah, and they'd check it off in the book, and then he would like go play. All right, so Timmy, I'm down here on vacation, and like I was saying earlier, a lot goes into vacation, especially when you have young kids. A lot of packing, a lot of stress. We got to bring a lot of things. And one thing I want to get into now that is kind of like a thing with dads that you must all go through, a baptism, if you will, for all fathers that are heading to the shore, and it's packing up the car. And it's trying to fit every single thing that you're going to need into this car strategically so that you can take all the things you need down to the shore. Every year they say it can't be done. They throw out the bags. They see the baby pack and plays. They see the stroller that needs to go in there, all the stuff. There's no way he could physically fit this into his car. And I make it work. And I get it in there like the greatest Tetris player that's ever been. Never to be topped. That is what real fathers do. We pack the car, we make it work. Everything goes in. I don't care if my kid can't see anything. If he's in a cage, that is everything that we need to bring down. Beach chairs, strollers, pack and plays, car seats, pillows, blankets, luggage. Her Royal Highness's best luggage.
Dude, the greatest that dude, I remember this like it was yesterday. Like my dad would, he was the king of that, right? Like he would be our, we would have like the station wagon outside and he'd pull it in the driveway and it was our job to bring the luggage, like whatever it was, like everything out, right? And then we would just like sit at the back of the car and he would just sit there and he'd be sitting there like playing it out in his head, and you'd walk up to him with like a piece of luggage and you'd be like, here you go, Dad. And he'd go, no, give me the other one. And he'd point it, like, and you're like,
Not yet.
what the hell? What do you mean? I'm just trying to help here. And
Is a
then
sense of satisfaction when you get that all in there. And it's in, and you shut that door. The last piece goes in, and you're like, I did it. I got it all in the car. I locked it up. Oh, wait, we forgot something. No.
Well, and then the best was finally like the car was fully packed, and then like the last thing that would go into the car would be, your pillows, like for the ride down, right? Like, oh yeah, we need pillows and blankets just in case, and then like the car would be packed with like sardines, and then like there'd be shit hanging over like the back seat, like into your seat, and there'd be it was like you got wedged into your seat, and then you'd throw your pillow against it, like the side door, the car door, and you'd be stuck there for like 2.5 hours on the drive to Wildwood. And then,
A boogie board just whacking you in the face every bump.
somehow someone would open the car door and you just fall out. And then,
Yeah,
like, you would
right.
have to push it back.
When I opened the back, I had to open it and like reach like to make sure nothing fell, and I had to strategically like place the thing there that would hold everything in. It was a mess, but we made it work.
I used to move furniture for my college job, and dude, like you would get a box truck, right? And we would move furniture, like you would move houses. Like they would like, oh, they pay you to come over and you take all the furniture out and then you pack it in. And like people were so like, they were so set on what furniture needed to go first. Like, oh, no, you have to take this first. And I'm like, lady, like you don't know how to pack the back of my truck. Like I'm not taking your bed set right now. Like that doesn't go first. Okay. I got to get the big stuff in here first. Like, and then
Right.
you'd pack up the whole truck and like it, very true to what you were saying. It's very much like a Tetris situation where,
Right.
hey, like you got to put this here and then you put some furniture pads on it and then you stick it to the corner. And I asked my buddy Joey, from Ball Birds. He's helped me move about 15 times. And I'm like, he's like, dude, I think you've used up all your favors. I'm like, I think I have. Yeah, you're right.
Moving's the worst. I feel like that's a lot of times why couples stay together sometimes. They live together and then it's just such a pain in the ass to move that they're just like, whatever, we'll make it work. I don't feel
My
like moving.
dude, I've looked at houses before and I've seen the house. Like it might have been a beautiful house, but like knowing what it's going to take to move into that house has turned me off. I'm like, I'm out. No way.
Yeah.
No fucking way. This is a great house, but I ain't fucking moving to this thing. Ain't no fucking way, dude.
No way. Oh man, I hear you. And moving is a pain. God bless Joey for helping you out. Let's right now, before we move on to our next subject, I do want to play our first call of the day. So let's hear our first call of the day.
Hey Tom, this is Joe. I'm at Grand right now. You could stay down the shore. Rachel's a better bartender. I'm not waiting for a beer. So, you know, when you get back, you can reach out and talk to me. Goodbye.
Timmy, as we said on the show, I am on vacation. JoJo, thank you for the call. The service is much better when I'm not there. Nobody waits when I'm working. Full beers all the time. We were talking about packing for vacation, loading up the car, the baptism you get as a father, trying to make it all fit. You're going on a trip soon, and I'd imagine you have to bring a good amount of stuff with you. No, Tim, you're headed to, well, you tell the people where you're headed
Yeah, no, I'm
and what
going.
you have to do.
I'm going to the Dominican Republic, Punta Cana, for an all-inclusive stay, right? Like it's going to be, I think I'm going for 4 days. No, 5 days, 4 nights.
Ooh.
It's going to be nice. It's going to be a fun time. But like I've been on these vacations before. Like I've been to Florida, like I've gone down to New Orleans. I've been on multiple day like vacations here before. And I just do the carry on. I do like the little quick, you know, little like 3 foot bag, you know, that you can stuff like a bunch of shit in and you're good to go. I'm getting told that I need a suitcase. People are telling me, like, no, you can't do a carry-on. You got to bring a suitcase. It's the beach and the whole. I'm sitting here thinking to myself,
What do you really
it's a,
need, Tim? You
I'm
need.
not even I'm not even going off the resort. Like,
Yeah.
and there's these all these restaurants that are like they're all pretty much the same. Like
Yeah, you need one shirt.
you probably wear the bathing suit and rewash the same shirt over and over again. No one gives a shit what you're
Yeah.
wearing.
Yeah.
Who are you impressing? I mean,
Maybe
look,
you
the
need
wet.
like what? You're going for 5 days. Let me see if I could guess what you would need. All right. You're going for what? 5 days?
Yeah.
All right, 5 days. You're going to wear the clothes that you wear down there. All right. You
Sure.
probably have some sneakers on there, a hat,
Yeah.
right? Then you go in there. Maybe you need a hat for the beach and the pool, maybe something, maybe a little more protective. I don't know. And you got a couple t-shirts, 5 days. I mean, what do you need? Four t-shirts, maybe two like button-down shirts and your swim trunks and maybe two pairs of shorts, five pairs of underwear, five pairs of socks. You're good to go.
Let me ask you this, Tom. How many swim trunks do I need?
One is what you need. Just one.
Right? Just
Yeah.
one, right?
That's
That's
all
all
you
I need.
need. That's all you
Like,
need.
well, I'm being told that I need at least two or three different pairs of swim trunks. Why do I need two to three? I don't even have swim trunks sometimes, Tom. I sometimes just go in my mesh shorts and wear my underwear in. I don't give a shit.
Oh, an official Roxburghian. You can take
Like,
the guy out of Roxburgh, but you can't take the Roxburgh out of the guy. He's officially from the neighborhood. It's a sin. He doesn't even wear a real bathing suit. That's
I
my Roxburgh impression for
don't know what that accent is, but I mean it's
Oh, it's a
spot
sin.
on. The content is spot on. I mean, I'm getting yelled at for but you not you there's no and I quote, there is no way you're wearing mesh shorts into the pool.
Timmy, where, when do you leave again?
Thursday morning.
Oh, man. Oh, somehow I want to find a pair. Like, do you ever see the guy that goes into the beach with jean shorts on? Do you ever
Yeah,
see those
yeah,
guys? Oh, I would
yeah,
buy you a pair of jean shorts
yeah, yeah.
just to see Diane's face when you're like coming down to the pool. Like, what? Like, I always wear short jeans in the pool. But yeah, if you have a
I
pair that's comfortable, I've only worn one pair this week. I have the one that got like the liner on the inside. It's a little floral
whoa,
design.
whoa, you rock the liner on the inside?
Well, this is a new age liner, Pop. This ain't like the old mesh like white liner. This is like it's basically like you're wearing underwear in these things. It's awesome.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I might
Oh,
have.
huh.
Hold on, let me see. I might have.
You
It
might
might
have
be
to
one of
send
my
those.
shorts right now. Let's see the. Let's see. Hold on. Let's see if you can see that. See that?
Ah, oh, look at that.
See that?
What kind of underwear? What kind of suit is that?
These are just regular shorts. These are some Lululemon jobbies right here.
Oh, well, I don't fit in them.
Well, dude, the liner's nice. Now, I will say there's been issues with people have had some chafing with the liner. So just a
Ugh.
free ball mesh short is good, but like whatever. I like the ones with the liner. I just got a new like pair of Hurley ones that have that like little mesh. Like it's like a, you know, it's basically like a fucking boxer brief in there, but it's
Love
like
that.
the waterproof one. So it does make it more comfortable, but they're comfortable as hell. And I wore it to the beach, hosed off, cleaned off in the shower, everything like that, hung it up, it dried, it wore it the next day. We go to the water park,
Yeah.
I'm wearing it. Like, I don't give a shit.
I don't need three bathing suits. Like, I don't need to be this like styling guy. What you see is what you get with the big
Yeah,
guy.
right. Yeah. I would
That's
say this one thing, and maybe this is a good segue into our next topic. Maybe if you were going on, say this was like a honeymoon or something like that, maybe a different story where you're going to be like going out for nice dinners. You might have some photo ops. You're trying to look your best for the honeymoon, the memories and stuff like that. Maybe then you'd want to be maybe a little more styling, a little more like, you know, I don't know how else to say it, but like just a little more stuff to go with.
debonair.
Debonair, yes. And that's where the pictures and stuff like this. Timmy, when you go on vacation, does your we had family pictures last night with the whole family. So in our packing, we had to add the traditional white linen shirt, the khaki shorts, the off like the blues were mixed in is blue, khaki, and white. That's everybody was wearing blue, khaki, and white. Blue khaki, and then we go to the beach, we meet a photographer, they take these photos. Now I will say this, I always love the photos after we're done. I really do like the photos, but the whole rest of it, what a pain in the fucking ass. Getting everyone set up, let's all go down. Everyone's like, oh man, are we really doing this? Like, I just want to relax. No. Let's go down here with a 20-month-old at 7:30 and try to
It's
keep him
Father's
going.
Day.
Yeah.
This is what your dad would want.
Yeah.
We're all
Yes.
doing it. I mean, there's
Yes.
nothing in the world that would make your father happier than taking photos on the beach at 7:30.
Group photos, and then it's like, all right, let's just separate the families because there's we're down here with like four families, like my brothers, my sister, their families, and it's like my mom and everybody. So we're all like, okay, now individually, now all together, and then let's get one this. Blah, 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 blah. All right, the couple now up there, like, let's see a nice kiss. The worst is when they say stare at each other, and you look at each other, and you're like, ah, yeah, there you are. It's so good to
You.
see you in this photo in front of my brothers and sisters and everything like that.
What
Like, we're so happy.
a great decision this was.
Oh, are any photos planned down there? Any photo ops, Tim? You're gonna get someone on the beach, hey,
No. I mean, this is more of a let's go down. Let's have, it's gonna be the first time that Diane and I are away for like I mean we've gone on vacation together, but like to an island is like this is kind of fun, right?
Yeah.
Like it's that's gonna be fun. So looking forward to it. Yeah, it's gonna be a fun weekend. Got a round of golf playing for down there. So we're gonna tee it up. Yeah, tee it up a little bit. 7 o'clock tee time on a Friday. That'll be fun.
Oh, that should be cool down at the Dominican. I will say this in this, we talked about it a bit last week. The Dominican Republic, Punta Cana, is one of the few times when your boy had an accident in his pants. And
Whoa.
yeah, it was I can remember two times in my life, and that was one of them. The
Oh.
first time I wouldn't even say it was a full-on accident. It was what we I guess would be described as a shart, but and I was much younger. And this time we go to the resort. Me and my now wife, girlfriend at the time, we go on this vacation, we set it up, she books the place, we're having it's a beautiful resort. And the second day we were there, we were in the hotel room the whole time. My wife was vomiting, very
Ooh.
sick, and we're like trying to tough it out, like you'll be our like let's see if we can make it work. And it just got to the point where we had to leave early. Terrible experience. They wanted to send us off the resort. I said, where are you sending us, some witch doctor or something? I'm not doing that. What are you talking about? And they wouldn't give me a refund for an excursion that we had planned the following day. They refused to give a refund. They threatened me. They said, well, we have all your credit card information, so we are going to charge you. And I'm like, it's not till tomorrow. We're sick because of the stuff that's going on in this resort. We're leaving early. Like, what do you mean you can't give me a refund? And they cornered me in a room, Timmy. It was not a fun situation. So we finally leave. I'm trying to help my wife, my girlfriend at the time, get her everything. I'm carrying this luggage. She's like dying. We've got to go. We go through the security. Sir, can you please raise your hands to go through the wanding in some like field that we were in, being wanded down with goats running around. Next thing you know, I raise my hands and I said, oh my God. And Nicole goes, what's wrong? Did you go to the bath or like do you have to go to the bathroom? I go, I think I just did. And she goes, and I look at her and I said, this is officially the worst day of my life. So I'm in the airport in Punta Cana, open air, and just
Hot as
has
hell.
gone, hot as
Yeah.
hell, sweating, goats running everywhere. And I said, I'm going to this restroom. I walk in the restroom. Thank God, in my carry-on luggage, I had a bathing suit. Clean up, throw everything out, put on the bathing suit. I ride home with the bathing suit on.
With or without lining.
It didn't have a liner at the time. This is years ago. This was like,
Hey.
this is probably 15 years ago. I don't even know. But
Yeah.
that was a heck of a time, a heck of a trip. And I officially called it Poopacana after that.
Very,
Tim,
very fitting.
very fitting. On this show, we make it fit. All right, everyone. You've heard it all here on this week's episode. Another great episode from Schmidt Lavelle. Coming live from Long Beach Island. I'm down here. I'm in the basement. Me and Timmy are recording. Sweating like a spitz in here. I don't even know what that means, but I've heard it before somewhere. So if it means anything bad, my apologies. New episodes every week. We love you. Thank you for listening. If you want to be a part of the show, Best way to do it is to give us a call at 215-948-OKGO. That's 215-948-6546. 215-948-OKGO. Give us a call. Leave us a message. Tell us a story, a topic, some advice maybe you'd want from Schmidt Lavelle. Tell Tommy sucks at bartending. Whatever it is, we'll have it on the show. We'll respond. And you'll be a part of Schmidt and Lavelle, the hottest growing show in all of podcasts. Timmy, before we sign off, is there anything you'd like to say to all the Schmidt and Lavelleites out there?
Tom, I do. I really have something to say, but I just can't think of it right now.
Oh, man. You know what? I did just hear some news. Justin Timberlake arrested on DUI charges. They're saying that this could really affect the NSYNC tour. You believe it, Timmy?
Seems like they're a little out of sync.
Oh, my God. New episodes every week. We love you. For Timothy Schmidt, my name's Tom Lavelle. Have a great rest of your week. Until next time, peace.